Happy Monday and warmest greetings from the First United Methodist Church of Orange in Southern California. This is We Are the Church. Well, friends, it's Martin Luther King Jr. Day. This is a celebration of the birth of this incredible leader and prophet who has influenced the country that we live in, and we have set aside a day for his holiday, which I think is appropriate. Today I want to read a couple of verses from the 137th Psalm and just reflect for a minute upon them. It says, "By the rivers of Babylon, there we sat down, and there we wept when we remembered Zion. On the willows there we hung up our harps, for there our captors asked us for songs, and our tormentors asked for mirth, saying, 'Sing us one of the songs of Zion.' But how could we sing the Lord's song in a foreign land? If I forget you, O Jerusalem, let my right hand wither, let my tongue cling to the roof of my mouth. If I do not remember you, if I do not set Jerusalem above my highest joy." Couple of things there. First of all, if anyone who is feeling it right now and is tired of the pandemic, and here we have a holiday and it's been good weather and we are still kind of, you know, shut down mode, if you're feeling it and it's kind of wearing on you, you're not alone. And I love the fact that there are psalms like this in our scriptures, which tell us that others were kind of in that place once in a while too. These people who were carried off into captivity in Babylon as part of the conquerors of Jerusalem's strategy was to take the best and the brightest, and not to put them to the sword, but to kidnap them and take them off so that they would bring their artisanship, their songs, their wisdom, their science, their mathematics, their skills as builders, and they would be put to work for the Babylonian economy. It was a rough blow to the people of Israel when Jerusalem fell, because it was considered to be a city that God would never allow to be taken down like that. And when the temple was destroyed, many people thought that that the God of the Babylonians, Marduk, had defeated the God of the Israelites, Yahweh, and that's how Jerusalem had fallen. So there in the ghettos of Babylon, they were faced with some hard choices, and some probably went down the street and joined the First Church of Marduk after that. But this is where our psalms began to be written down. This is where the oral traditions of our faith began to be codified and written down on scrolls. And the people of Israel discovered a remarkable thing, that God wasn't tied to the geography of Israel or to Jerusalem, but that God was free to meet them in the many different places. And so the covenant community of God continued on, despite the destruction of Jerusalem and despite all the hardship. Even as the Church of God today, despite all the hardships and the things we see around us, continues to flourish in one respect. Now it's hard on us, but we're still finding God on a day-to-day basis. And God's steadfast love has not left us. We are tempted from time to time when we get worn down to take matters into our own hands and to kind of lose our courage and forget to trust the Lord a little bit. I wanted to read to you, you're all familiar with Dr. Martin Luther King's dream speech from the Washington Mall. And, you know, you're probably going to hear it two or three times today. But I wanted to share with you another quote of his that has always been meaningful to me when I find my sense of courage is kind of wearing thin and I'm growing impatient with the circumstances. King said, "I believe that that unarmed truth and unconditional love will have the final word in reality. And that is why right, temporarily defeated, is still stronger than evil triumphant." That's a powerful word of witness, especially when you consider that King himself would give his life not long after he said these words for the cause he believed in. I believe that unarmed truth and unconditional love will have the final word in reality. Only a true follower of Christ Jesus could say such a thing, and it's a powerful word for us today. So remember that no matter how the circumstances seem, no matter what our tormentors are asking of us, in the end, even if it's temporarily defeated, the rightness of God's way is still stronger than any evil triumphant. Let's pray. God, thank you for the witness of those who've gone before us and those who are remembered this day as those who stood on the side of right, not with fangs bared or with arms and weapons in their hands, but with only the tools of your unconditional love and of the unarmed truth. So, Lord, may we also be witnesses of that truth and love. For love, indeed, is the only thing that can ever make a friend from an enemy. And so, Lord, we thank you for the witness of Dr. Martin Luther King, and for his presence in our life, and for the changes that he has brought to our community and culture. And we thank you for all those down through the years who have given their life in service to your loving kingdom. May we also be counted among them. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Well, enjoy your holiday today, friends, and make good use of it. And remember to wash your hands and to read a psalm to tell somebody that you love them. I'll see you tomorrow.